engine from Mk7, engine review. This is the Italian RP for gas performance parts, the connectors, the pistons, the wrist pin, and the bearings. So now, a couple of things about the balancing, about the weight of the parts. I'm gonna compare it with Mk6. Mk6, let us say, the pistons, between these four pistons, I have a 0.1 of a gram difference. And before on the Mk6, I was have 0.15 of a gram. Very similar. Then, on the connecting rods, I have, on these connectors, I have plus minus 0.35 of a gram. And before I was have 0.35, I was have total 0.15 of a gram. 0.15 of a gram on the previous connecting rods, and on these connecting rods, 0.35 of a gram. The difference. There is a but. On the small end for the previous connecting rods, I mean this piece here up, I was have plus minus 1 gram. 1 gram on the Mk6. On these connecting rods, on the small end, I have 0.3 of a gram difference. On the big end, on these connecting rods, I have 0.25 gram difference. And on the previous connecting rods, I was have, on the big end, 1.05 of a gram difference. So, that means if I translate it for my mind, what does mean that one? Since the previous connecting rods, there was in general 0.15 of a gram. That means in total, not the big end, not the small end. In total, there was have a difference 0.15 of a gram. But I was have on the small end 1 gram plus minus difference. That means there is a possibility, let us say, one connecting rod was 189.5 here, and there was another connecting rod, let us say this connecting rod or the other connecting rod, it was 191.5. That means 2 grams different. This making the average plus minus 1 gram. Here I have 0.1 of a gram. So this is something that the bottom section, the lower section of the connecting rod, I have plus minus 0.6 of a gram. On the Mk6, I was have on the half on the bottom part plus minus 0.9. Plus minus 0.9, here I have 0.6. So for me it's much better, since you have exactly the same shape, it's exactly the same, as less as possible is the difference. For me, it's much better. Keeping in mind that with the company that we are dealing, with this company, I explained to them, I asked them if it's possible to swap the connecting rod. I mean, what I mean by that. If I saw something that I don't like it, I can give it back. Up to now, it never happened. If it happened, and keep in mind that we have, let us say, 50 or 60 connecting rods. So it's not only this set. If I see any problem, or if the weight is not matching, very easy, I'm going to the office, I'm getting another four connecting rods, and I'm counting to see to match all of the connecting rods, perfect to be the same weight. I mean, from 50 connecting rods in stock, you can choose four pieces to be exactly the same weight. The same thing also, this is the same thing also for the piston and for the wrist pin. It's exactly the same principle. For the pistons and the wrist pin, the ARP bolts, I have the same difference like I have always, all the time with the ARP, 0.1 of a gram only. Actually, it's 0.05 of a gram, the difference plus minus. That means I have like always 26.4 and 26.5 grams. Keep in mind that the altitude has difference. I mean, if I get, because I'm counting on 0.1 of a gram, if I go, let us say, 10 meters high, you're going to have some difference. I don't know the altitude right now where I am. Most probably I'm on the sea level. So then another one difference actually, but I have to start the lights. It's the piston rings. If you watched on the previous video, the piston rings, there was not written anything on the piston ring. The cut of the piston ring, it was lousy. It was not the best cut for me. This is my opinion. Maybe somebody else will gonna say that's the best. This is my opinion. If you see this piston rings, except of the letter that you can see over there, that's written the letter, you can see, now we're gonna try to make it on the camera. Yeah, be patient guys. You can see that the finishing, the cutting on the edge, it's perfect. It's smooth, does have an edge. You can see clearly the lip from this side. This is the first piston ring, the top piston ring, and this is the secondary. Same story with the second. Has very nice finishing. If you make it upside down, has also the lip here. Yeah, I need the light. Just one second. Alright, now with the light it's gonna be a little bit much better to see what I'm talking about. About the finishing. That's much better. So this is pretty much the difference on the previous piston rings with these piston rings. This is the connection bearings. They are coated. And I'm gonna get one set. I'm gonna sand it with sandpaper. It's just only to prove that it's not paint. It's really coated. Actually, I already washed it once with the petrol, and I have to wash it again before I install it. So the finish with the petrol is gonna come away because my finger is like a sandpaper. All right, that's it. Let's continue. After playing a little bit with the weight of the connecting rod, with the wrist pin, the piston, connection bearings, connection bolts, all this stuff, I end up to make a combination without removing materials, and I have from number 1 to number 4 cylinder in the total weight to be plus minus 0.35 of a gram, the big end to be plus minus 0.1 of a gram, and the small end to be plus minus 0.3 of a gram. That means if you have a scale that's counting 1 gram, you're gonna be all gonna be equal. No need even to remove material, no need even to touch anything in this case. Very good. Excellent. I cannot be more happy than this. No need to have a headache, that's why. I didn't calculate something. This is, I'm continuing the video. I think I'm doing something. On the small end, I have plus minus 0.3 of a gram, but I think calculate the C-safe, this one for the wrist pin, the safe for the wrist pin. I have two that are 0.2 of a gram, 1.2 of a gram, and this I have 0.1 of a gram. So if I put on the small end, the 0.2 is gonna be the plus minus 0.3, 0.2, it's gonna be plus minus 0.1, the small end. It's even better. That means the small end is gonna end up to be 0.1 of a gram plus minus 0.1 of a gram, the bottom end, the big end, and the small end 0.1, the big end 0.1, and gonna be plus minus 0.35 in average in total, but here we're gonna have 0.2 of a gram. This is the lightest. No, it's not gonna be, yes, it's gonna be in average in total weight, it's gonna be 0.2 of a gram, since it's gonna be the C safe, this one gonna be 0.2 of a gram more heavy. That means it's gonna be 8 to 0.3 5 5. That means this is gonna be 0.25 of a gram.
It's coming better and better. Yay!
Okay, let's continue. After that, I have to fix the pistoning gap. The pistonings, they have all the same weight. Doesn't have any difference. Just I want to see, I'm going to show you later on, that since the cylinders are perfect straight, they are okay and doesn't have any difference. You remember the previous piston rings, when I put, before I touched, before I make a gap, fix the gap, there was difference from each cylinder to the other. Not for the cylinder, but for the pistonings, there was a problem. There was not the correct size of the pistonings. That's why I fixed the gap. Now, I will gonna fix also the gap for these pistonings, but I want to show you how it is on each cylinder. That's exactly the same gap, even without touching it. Yeah, pretty much that's it. Let me continue now. Top piston ring. I didn't touch it, just only I want to count it to see that they are the same in all of the cylinders. I have the 0.25 millimeter, 0.1 of an inch, 0.25 tight. That means the 20 is gonna pass easily inside. 0.2 actually. 0.2 it's passing. 0.2 it's passing. 0.2 it's passing. And 0.2 it's passing. That means the pistonings are exactly the same and the cylinders are the same. Doesn't matter if I get the piston ring from here and I put it here, or if I put it here, it's gonna be exactly the same. So, how much I'm gonna fix this gap, I'm gonna fix in all of them. And at the end, we're gonna verify that it's correct. Let's try now the second piston. This one is the stock piston, it's 82.5 millimeters, and this burn here, it's because the oil jet
it's spraying all, actually it's coming everywhere here on the, down the piston, but this is the exhaust side, and it's more hot, that's why it's burn, has a burn. From one side it's clean, the half it's clean, the other half it's hot. So let's check now the second. Let's start with 0.2 knots. It could be 0.2, let's go to 0.3 direct. 0.35, it's coming inside. No, let's go 0.3, it's coming. It's 0.35 is not coming, so it's probably 0.36. 0.31, since it's coming a bit more easy inside, 0.31, something like that. Let's see this one. Yeah, it's 0.30 exactly. 0.30 exactly. 0.30. So except for the first one is 0.31 of a millimeter, as I can feel on the filler gauge. All the rest 0.3. They are excellent. They are perfect. Let's fix it now, the gap, to make it properly for this application, and finally to check that we are okay. Nice. Just a second. There we have the pistons that are ready. Continue with the pistoning. These are the parts for the engine on the, of the Mk7. We have the cylinder head gasket. We have the valve seals. They sent to me in this bag, I don't know why. We have the exhaust valves. This is for the turbo manifold gasket. These are the two bolts for the camshafts, the solenoid actually. You have to put a new one. It's like the for the crankshaft and the single head. Here is the water pump. Actually, I need also the rest of the water pump. They didn't bring it to me until now. Because from the other side there is one motor, like a, it looks like the, like how it's the for the window motor, for the window mechanism. It's arranging. It's acting like a thermostat. It's opening a path, different path. Then we have here the tensioner, timing chain tensioner. Then is the other tensioner for the balancers. 26.7 mm, I don't remember which one. Then we have the crankshaft seal, the rear one, and this is the front one. Then we have seal guides, one fly that's pissing me off. Seal, seal, one bolt, what's that? I don't know which one. What? Take a look, what's that? This looks like exhaust. What they are sending these guys? This is under of investigation to see what's that. Then I order this small pipe, this hose with this, because the stock one is usually these things that they are cracking, and this is already cracked while open it. They didn't give it to me assembly, they give me separate the pump and separate the fitting, no problem, just only gonna use these clamps, the original one, it looks nice. Then this for the oil pickup tube, the seal, This one, I don't have a clue. I'm gonna see which one gonna be. They have a tool. I hope these guys don't send me extra parts for no reason. This is for the cover up for the cylinder head ventilation. Let's see. This is for the timing cover. This is from where I'm pulling the tension, the timing tension of the locking. Then I have only one bolt, and this is supposed to be for the flywheel. I didn't find any other. Perfect. Go figure out. This is the oil pump for the Mk7. I already had it before. Actually, I received this pump with a pump from the Mk6. The two seals for the timing cover. The main seal for the timing cover, the plastic, the upper part. Then we have, this is for the cylinder head bolts, the four Torx, 30 Torx that's coming front. Then this is supposed to be for the gear, for the balancer. There is one gear. And one of these seals, what you see before, it has to be for this gear. Behind of this gear has one seal. Then I have one aluminum 30 Torx bolt. Just only one piece. I'll see where it's going, that one. These are the bolts for the crankshaft, from the crankshaft caps. This is the big one, and this is the small that's come from the side. I already use it. Then timing, this is a chain for the balancer. This is the chain for the balancer. This is the timing chain, the main. And I don't have, again, I don't have for the oil pump, the chain, like the same thing in the Mk6. I don't have the guides. I have the half guides here. I don't have all the guides. And then I have the damper pulley bolt. This time they sent to me in a box. Usually they send me only the bolt. Now they send it also with the box and part number. Take a look. I need the rest of the parts sacked. Okay. They are missing lots of parts. They are missing, let us say, like the caps here, the gasket for the vacuum pump. It's missing the chain for the oil pump. It's missing the guides. They are missing lots of things. Okay. What you... Let me close the camera. 1 second. I didn't show you that one in the previous video with the engine from the Mk6. I'm gonna show you this one on the Mk7. It's the same thing. This, you're putting on the deck. You make it zero. You tap on zero. 1 second, because I tied it. And then bring each piston at the top of the sender, and you see if it's like the original one, so you don't have any problem with the clearance with the valves. How much the clearance, let's say the piston with the deck. It's 1/1000 of an inch, the difference. Is you have to do it in all of the pistons, and with this way you can see even the, it's 1/1000 of an inch also. With this way, well, can you give me 3 seconds only, please? With this way you can see even if there is any bent connecting rod. Let's say if you have one bent connecting rod, you're not gonna reach where it's supposed to reach. You're gonna have different values. Yeah, let's spin also a crank. That's it. The engine block, it was the easy part. The bottom end. Let's go now for the headache. Sometimes I wish the cars to be 2-stroke and not 4-stroke. At least I cannot touch the ports for the exhaust. Something is that. Yeah, it's not in so bad condition. And I have also the exhaust valves, so I'm not gonna be pain in the butt to sand the exhaust valves, because I'm gonna use a new one. The intake, because it's colder, they're sanding it fast. Let's go and clean it and prepare it. Over there, it's the engine block with a bag, waiting for the cylinder head. It's gonna take at least 2 days. 1 to 2 days.